Welcome to this presentation about the framing analysis of foreign fighters and their families. In this work, we aim to investigate the framing of the discourse about foreign fighters and their families, but also to identify which are the users and what type of actors are leading the debate on this issue online, on social media, but also to see whether we can find differences across countries. To do this research, we rely on a selection of tweets from the UK and from France, which have been extracted using a sample of keywords. Then, because we want to first assess which frames are prevalent and which are the actor types, we annotate a sample of tweets. The results show that the main actors mentioned in the tweets are the fighter spouses on the UK side, but the children on the French side. Then all other prevalent actors are extremist groups, religious institutions, but also government and journalists. The reason to be a foreign fighter that is mostly mentioned in the tweets is the brainwashing or the support to a broader community. Then the depiction of foreign fighters is done through the lens of a theorist or the intruder's picture. Then the response to foreign fighters mainly opposes two camps, user who thinks we should stop them from returning and user who thinks that on the reverse, we should free them to return. On the generic frame, we see that the policy prescription and evaluation, but also cultural identity, as well as legality and morality and ethics are prevalent frames in both countries.
Next, we categorize the accounts according to certain attributes, like their stance, being related to media and anonymity. Overall, we found out that media-related accounts, non-anonymous accounts, and accounts who do not involve in propaganda are more likely to mention frames, external regulation and reputation, health and safety, legality, constitutionality, and jurisdiction. Meanwhile, the accounts that are anonymous and do anti-government propaganda are more likely to mention frames, economic quality of life, and security and defense. We had several difficulties in the project. We initially planned to use the annotations as training data so that we could classify all tweets according to frames. However, we couldn't achieve a reliable classification of general frames, even though we used state-of-the-art off-the-shelf language models and classification algorithms that are used for the same task in the literature. The reasons for that might be because the topic is too specific or the task is too complex. Additionally, coding actors with respect to their political stance was also challenging due to the subjectivity of the matter. We plan to develop a classifier to automatically code the actors as a follow-up verb. Thank you.